to Who Wants to Be a Millionaire? I'm your host, Sandy Coast, and today we are here with Jane Doe, focusing on occupational therapy. So let's begin. The first question is, if Johnny wants to learn to ride a bike, who should set goals that are likely to attain? A, the teacher, B, Johnny, C, Johnny's mom, or D, Johnny's mom's sister's friend?
This is a really hard question, Sandy.
It is.
I think I would like to go with B, Johnny.
Okay, and why are you going with Johnny?
Because in this case, Johnny would be the learner, and so he's more likely to attain his own goals.
I like it.
Is that your final answer?
That's my final answer.
That is the correct answer. Good job. Okay, the second question is worth $5,231. So, the question is, how can a therapist prepare Johnny to be successful in first grade? A, give him candy. B, teach him procrastination. C, use worksheets. Or D, practice in different situations.
Sandy, I'm between B and D.
Okay. And why? Why is that? Which one?
I'm leaning more towards D.
Okay.
Because if he practices in different situations, that kind of encourages generalization and discrimination.
Can you explain that answer a little bit more?
I can. So generalization is being able to apply, you know, what you learn in one situation for another, what's appropriate in another. Which different situations would help, and then generalization is taking what's appropriate behavior for one situation as opposed to another situation.
Okay, so what is your final answer going to be?
I'd like to do D.
D?
This is my final answer.
Okay.
Your real final answer?
My real final answer.
Almost done.
And yes, that is the correct answer. Good job. Okay, now question 3 is worth $8,502. When Johnny is learning to shower, what should he understand? Star, what? Circle, why? Smiley face, how? Or square, all of the above?
Sandy.
I'm making them hard for you.
I know. Well, he needs to know what he's doing.
Okay.
And why. And how to shower. So, my answer will be square, all of the above.
Is that your final answer?
That's my final answer.
Okay. And that is the correct answer. Good job! On to question 4, Jane Doe. The question is worth $15,635.03. If Johnny can't reach his big wheel pedals, what should his mom encourage him to do? A, adapt his pedals. B, get a smaller trike. C, all of the above and under. And D, don't use his pedals.
Oh.
Now let me remind you that you do have your 3 lifelines still to use. 50-50, phone a friend, and pull the audience. They're all still available. I noticed you were struggling.
Thank you. Sandy, can I phone a friend?
You may. You may indeed. So we're going to pause for a second while we phone the friend, and we will be right back.
Do, 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 do.
Hello?
Hi! Rachel, how are you?
I'm good. What's up?
Oh, nothing much. I'm just on Who Wants to Be a Millionaire.
Oh, awesome.
So I need your help with a question.
Ooh, okay, I'll do my best.
All right, I don't have much time, but the question is, if Johnny can't reach his big wheel pedals, what should his mom encourage him to do? A, adapt pedals. B, get a smaller trike. C, all of the above and under. D, don't use pedals.
Okay, that's a tough one. I understand why you're struggling. What was A again?
Adapt the pedals.
Okay. I think it's C.
All of the above and under?
Yeah, that's what I'm gonna go with.
Alright, well, thank you.
Alright, hope you do well.
Thanks.
Bye.
Bye. Alright, so after getting off the phone,
mm-hmm.
I'm gonna go with Rachel and say C. All of the above and under.
Is C your final answer?
I mean, they're all innovative solutions. So yes, C is my final answer.
Okie dokie. Let's see what C gets us.
Oh, this is suspenseful.
And that is the correct answer. Very nice. Good job. And we are back on Who Wants to Be a Millionaire? So, our next question is worth $26,912.62. The question is, Johnny has anxiety before his first spelling test. What should Miss Honey do? A, let Johnny skip the test. B, Miss Honey is not Johnny's teacher. C, tell Johnny it's normal to be nervous. Or D, give Johnny all the answers.
Well, if I was Johnny, I would want all the answers.
Yeah.
But I think it would be C. Tell him it's normal to be nervous.
C? Why are you thinking C?
Well, anxiety or being nervous affects everybody in different ways. And the optimal level of anxiety for each individual, it should be identified so the learning situation can be, you know, regulated accordingly. So, my final answer is C.
C? C it is. Let's see if that's right. And yes, you have got another one right. Good job. Question number 6 is worth $537,160. Johnny wasn't paying attention in class. What should the teacher realize to help him learn? A, she needs to smack him with a ruler. B, he needs a sparkly pencil. C, he has to want to learn. Or D, Johnny is in the wrong class.
Ooh. I would guess C, Johnny has to want to learn.
Okay, C, is that your final answer?
Yeah, because the teacher has to design place that enhances learning. So pretty much she can lead Johnny to water, but she can't make him drink.
Okay. Sounds like a legit answer to me. Let's see if it's right. And it is correct.
Wow.
Once again. Good job. And here we are with the $1 million question. Are you ready for this?
I'm ready.
You are. Okay. The $1 million question is, who is Johnny? A, her. B, him. C, my dog. Or D, the man behind the camera.
All right, so my dog. Is that my dog?
No, my dog.
So, okay, my dog.
No, no, my dog. My dog is Johnny.
Your dog's Johnny.
No, no, I mean, that is the question. My dog is Johnny.
Yeah, the question is, who is Johnny?
Yes, and my dog is the option. Not your dog, my dog.
Okay, so if his name's the option, go ahead, let's not see. Can I use 50-50?
You may indeed. I'm going to mark out two of these choices. It is not my dog.
That's what I thought.
And it is not him.
All right. Johnny. Johnny. I would like to say A. She is Johnny.
This huge research paper coming up on Friday, and I just don't know what to do right now. It's too hard.
That sounds like a really complicated task. Luckily for you, our services breaks them down into more simple tasks.
Okay.
So, first, you would need to brainstorm.
Okay, so I probably need paper. Pencil. Okay, so
good
I can get
job.
Some ideas down.
So that's your first task. So after you brainstorm, you need to do some research. So what would you need for that more simple task?
Probably need these. Probably don't need that.
No, not a toothbrush. No.
Okay.
All right, so now you have two tasks. Let's bring in a third to actually write the paper.
Well, it has to be a typed paper, so can't use my paper here. So I'll use this laptop. There we go.
Yay! Now your big complicated task is down to three simple tasks.
Thanks for all the help.
To be a teacher! Good evening, everyone, and welcome to our special show. Today is special because we're having some University of Findlay faculty and students join us today. Please welcome our teachers, Professor Clousing and Professor Cox. And now, our daring student, Emily Stout. Now, Emily, do you believe that you are smart enough to be a teacher?
I know I am.
Great. Now let's get this show on the road. Our first question. The teacher must move at a rate that is comfortable for the learner. What are the strategies to follow? A. Provide one-on-one learning for those who do not understand. B. Move quickly through the lesson. C. If the student takes longer to learn, they must take rest periods. Or D. A and C. Please record your answers. All right. Now, let's please show your answers. All right. And the correct answer is D, A and C.
Are you kidding me?
By taking these steps, a teacher can better the learning environment and make the student comfortable and more willing to learn.
Good job.
Yeah. Thank you.
Good. Next question. How is the intelligence of an individual taken into consideration when you are a teacher? A. Determine how bright the individual is. B. If they are below average, choose more simplistic words. C. Select appropriate activities. Or D. All of the above. Please record your answers. Alrighty, now will you please show your answers to this lovely audience? Good, good. And the correct answer is D, all of the above. This allows the teacher to better know the student and help the student learn more productively.
That was a trick question.
That was
terrible.
Your stuff.
Oh, okay.
Okay, don't get feisty now, guys. You have more time to better. Alright, next question. All the following are aspects to consider when evaluating energy level, except A, taking into consideration how fast an individual gets tired, B, is a lot of physical activity needed, C, does the individual prefer sitting or standing when participating, or D, the hyper or hypoactivity of the student. Please record your answers. No cheating, no cheating.
No cheating.
All right, now let's show this audience your answers. Oh. And the correct answer is D, the hyper or hypoactivity of the student. Looks like our student is doing very well.
I got this next one, okay, guys?
Moving on.
I promise.
Which of the following apply to the aspect of physical health? Please select all that apply. A, seeing and hearing. B, number of toes. C, coordination. D, sensation. E, length of hair. Please record your answers. Looks like our teachers are pretty confident. Let's see how their answers play out. Okay, please show the audience your answers.
What?
And the correct answer is A, C,
yes!
And D.
Finally got one right, guys. Stepping up.
I'm getting this next one.
I told you I had
I'm going to come back here.
Okay, folks. Moving on. Is it appropriate to consider age when planning activities? True or false?
I don't like the difficult questions.
Tough.
Why? It's better than multiple choice. 50%.
Our teachers are getting a little feisty. I think they're a little concerned. All right, let's show the audience your answers. And the correct answer is true.
Yes.
In your face.
Age is very important to consider because some activities that are enjoyable to a child age 5 are definitely not enjoyable to a teenager age 16. And therefore, the 16-year-old would not be engaged and they wouldn't learn very well. All right, moving on. When dealing with different culture groups, what is the most important factor to remember? A. Make sure the individual knows your personal views. B. Never try to change one's values or beliefs. C. Never take values or beliefs into consideration. Or D. None of the above. All right. Let's see your answers.
Interesting.
And the correct answer is B. Never try to change one's values or beliefs.
Good job. That was a good one.
It is important to understand other cultures and their values and adapt to make them comfortable and let them know what they believe is correct, whether it's different from your beliefs or not. Are we ready to move on? Okay.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
All right, next question. It is not important to take men and women's roles into consideration, true or false. Please record your answers. Alrighty, let's see those answers. Okay. And the correct answer is false.
Yes.
Men and women can be different in many ways.
Man.
So it is very important to consider that in order to have them be engaged and further their learning.
Shit. What? Just play the game.
Okay, moving on. In order to have the individual be active in the learning process, a teacher must select all that apply. A. Provide motivation and encouragement. B. Go off the past experiences with students similar to students in that age group. C. Knowing what is important to the client. Or D. Provide student with topics they're interested in. Please record your answers. All right, looks like Professor Cox is pretty confident. Let's see how this one plays out. Please show your answers. All right. The correct answer is A, C, and D.
Forgot one. Are you sure that was right?
I'm positive. All right, let's move on now. If a student is satisfied with the action, they are more likely to repeat it. Which of the following are ways to create positive outcomes? A. shaping, positive reinforcement, punishment, and providing no feedback. B, providing feedback, negative reinforcement, punishment, and token economy. Or C, shaping, positive reinforcement, providing feedback, and token economy. I got this one. All right. Seems like this is a little tough one for Professor Clouding over here.
Yeah, you could say that.
All right, let's see those answers. And the correct answer is C, shaping, woo-hoo! Positive reinforcement, providing feedback, and token economy. All right, moving on. We're running into the home stretch here, folks. It is important to have goal-directed acts, but it is not important to show that mistake and multiple trials are normal. True or false?
Do you have a question?
No.
Tricky question. Yeah. All right, let's see those answers. And the correct answer is false. It is important to show this as normal because no one's perfect and they should not get discouraged. Rather, let mistakes help them learn. Moving on. Last question. To better facilitate one's learning, they must practice and use frequent repetition. True or false? See those answers. And the correct answer is true.
Woo!
Oh man.
It takes considerable repetition before a skill is so well learned that you can do it automatically without having to think about it. Well, looks like that is the end of our show, folks. Emily, you did great. It looks like you are smart enough to be a teacher.
I learned from the best.
As far as Professor Clousing and Professor Cox over here, I don't know. They might be losing their jobs. Congratulations, Emily.
Thank you.
Now, folks, tune in next week when we test the skills of a Bowling Green State University student. Good night.
Oh.
Lately, Kristen has been having problems getting out of her chair. She has started to seek out occupational therapy intervention.
Hi, Kristen.
Hi, we're your OTs today. We're going to help you get out of this chair.
Okay, that would be nice.
With the help of occupational therapy, Kristen will soon be able to get up from her chair independently.
Thank you.
See, you could do it. Just follow what we told you.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.
Thanks.
The next day. After occupational therapy, Kristen can take the steps to get up out of her chair on her own. And she can now go about her daily occupations with ease and enjoyment.
Wow, I am so glad I saw that occupational therapy.
Hi, and welcome to today's episode of Family Feud.
Woo-hoo!
Today, we have the Wanahaka Loogie family. They're from Fishbowl, Ohio. Wanahaka Loogies, introduce yourself.
I'm Marlin.
I'm Flo.
I'm Squirt.
And I'm Nemo.
Yeah!
All right, Wanahaka Loogies, today's topic is teaching methods. A teaching method is a means of presenting the task to the individual or group. Most can be implemented in a one-to-one situation between the therapist and the person seeking help or in a group situation. Let's have the males come on down.
How you doing,
Dad? Okay, Wanahaka Loogies, this is your first question of the day. What is the most basic teaching method where imitation is led by the therapist?
Demonstration and performance. An example of this could be where the OT folds a towel a certain way and the patient has to imitate what they're doing.
Correct.
question is, list three things used when problem solving.
Define, outline, and selecting.
And what is an advantage or disadvantage?
Problem solving is good because once you learn something one time, you can use that skill to keep learning in the future. Bad thing is your client has to be completely focused and it may take many tries.
Correct. All right, Wanahakalugis, we're tied. The next question. This type of teaching method is frequently used in child's play, and art materials are used to help this. What is it?
Exploration and discovery.
Correct. Yes! Next question. When would a therapist use audiovisual aids?
Well, this is an audiovisual aid right now. But you would also use it as a therapist when you can't be around the client and need them to see it multiple times or different people to see it multiple times.
Correct.
You're going down. Welcome back, audience. And now can I have the female members of the Wanahakalugi family come up? Flo and Squirt.
Woo! Yeah!
You guys ready?
Yeah.
Okay. The first question of the day. Speed and accuracy are the main focus of what teaching method?
What is repetition and practice?
And can you give an example?
Typing on a keyboard.
Woo! She got it right. On to the next question, rebuttal time. What is the method focusing on one specific behavior separate from a cause and effect relationship?
Oh. Behavioral management.
Can you give an example of that?
Giving a child a cookie when they say thank you.
Exactly. Yeah. All right. Question number three. How are explanation and discussion useful?
Planning a task in advance.
Can you give an example?
Preparing for your first day of school.
Let's see if that's right, folks. It is!
Woo! Woo! Coming back.
Okay, fourth question. What is the advantage of role-playing and simulation?
Trying out the activity before you do the activity.
Oh, correct again! This is a tie. We got a tiebreaker.
I got this, guys.
Tiebreaker. What teaching method is an approach to imparting knowledge and information?
Patient education.
Can you give an example?
Clarify, please?
Who may be included in a patient education session?
A spouse, child, or other type of family member.
I don't know, guys. I don't know.
What?
Yes! Wow! And she takes the lead. Thank you for coming on today's show.
Thank you for watching today's episode of The Family Feud. Today's winners are the parents.
Woo!
Yeah!
Come on, kids.
Come on, kids. We may have won today, but in this family, we're all winners.
We'd like to go to George House.
I just failed physics. So.
Again, what's new?
Come on in.
You're on Cash Cab.
What?
Would you like to play?
Yeah.
This is OT Cash Cab. We have some OT questions for you. Can you handle that?
I think we can.
All right.
I hope so.
All right.
I should probably buckle up.
All right,
yeah.
So George House.
George House.
All right, let's go.
Go.
All right, so the rules of Cash Cab. There's 10 questions, and you get each question you get right, you get $100, and then if you get 3 wrong, you're out, and I kick you out of my car.
Oh, man.
All right. We got this.
All right, so you guys ready to start?
Yep.
Oh, yeah.
All right. Are you ready for question one?
Yes.
What is the therapeutic approach that encourages social skills, such as talking and working in a group situation of 8 to 12 members? Is it A, perpendicular activity group, B, economic group, C, activity group, or D, control group?
Activity group.
Ding, 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 ding. Woo!
$100.
Dollar bill.
Question number two. What is the term used to refer to the technique of categorizing tasks or toys into degrees of difficulty or complexity? Is it A, adapted activity, B, graded activity, C, adapted structure environment, or D, none of the above?
Graded activity?
Ding, 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 ding! Woo! Woo! Shimmer, I'm going to show you a video and you have to tell me what the answer is.
Hi Anne, how are you doing today?
Good.
My name's Erica. I'm from Occupational Therapy. I'm here today to help you with your range of motion and your fine motor skills. I know you've been struggling with your arms. How high can you lift your arm today? That's about it. All right, well, I got you this equipment. It's a long-handled toothbrush, so if you want to try. Alright, thank you.
Adapted activity.
Correct! Nice job! Another $100. And we are at a stop sign. Stop sign challenge, double or nothing. No strikes against you if you get it wrong.
Are you ready?
Yes.
Alright. A person learning to drive needs to practice in a safe environment first before tackling freeway traffic at rush hour. The real-world environment is also called A, the natural environment, B, normal environment, C, common environment, or D, everyday environment.
Normal environment.
Yes, that is correct. Another, that's double. That's $200.
Oh, yeah.
Good question. I'm going to show you a video, and you have to tell me what the answer is.
Therapy today.
I am.
All right, well, today I figured we would work on tying the shoes.
Okay. What do I do?
Well, what do you think you do first?
Do you remember? Not really. You take each of these, this hand,
and then you're going to cross them, and you're going to put one behind the other, and then loop it through this hole. Pull them tight, make two bunny ears, make them hug, and then loop them through, and pull it tight. Good job, Lindsay.
Is that it?
That's it for today.
All right.
One-to-one approach.
That is correct!
Woo!
In normal activity sequencing, what would someone with balance problems have to do in order to get dressed in the morning?
Shout out!
Yeah! Woo! All right, we're going to go find someone. Hey, you! We need a shout out. We're on Cash Cab, and we don't know the answer.
All right.
Okay. Our question is, in a normal activity sequencing, what would someone with balance problems have to do in order to get dressed?
Well, it would probably have to be that they have to minimize the amount of time that they get up and stand, so you would have them pull like their undergarments and their pants up at the same time instead of having them get up twice.
We're gonna go with that.
Mm-hmm.
Yep,
what she
right
said.
There. Correct! Alright, we are coming up to a stop sign. Stop sign challenge, double or nothing.
Awesome. Yeah.
In normal developmental sequencing, what would be the steps for a child who wishes to be able to run but can only stand with support at the moment?
We're gonna go with walk first and then run.
Nope, I'm sorry. The correct answer would be to stand without support, then walk, then speed walk, then run.
Close.
$50? You can't do that. Sorry, guys.
I'm all excited when I know it. Sorry.
All right. In what environment is there more structure and less risk involved?
I know. It is adaptive and structured environment.
Ding, 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 ding. Another $100.
Yeah.
We're going shopping.
Question 5. This therapeutic approach permits the therapist and individual to examine in detail the steps or processes that compose an activity or task. All right, yeah. You have one more shout out.
Oh, thank goodness.
Who are you going to ask?
These fools.
Right there.
Hold it.
What up?
How we doing?
Do you guys want to hear the question?
I'd love to.
All right. This therapeutic approach permits the therapist and individual to examine in detail the steps or processes that compose an activity or task.
I know this, dude.
Task analysis?
Yeah.
Correct. Ding, 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 ding. Yay. Good job, boys! All right, time for your last question.
Woo.
Are you ready?
Oh yeah, we got this.
All right, we've arrived at your destination. Time for your final question. Are you ready?
Yes,
we got this.
All right, what is the process of examining the problem and giving advice to a person as to how to solve the problem?
Counseling?
Is that your final answer?
We'll go counseling.
100%
sure?
Sure.
Sorry, guys. That's wrong.
No!
The correct answer is consulting. Damn. It's a good try, though. You still win your money. Thanks for playing Cash Cab. Hope you had a good time.
Oh,
here's your money you won.
It was fun.
Thank you.
Thanks.
No problem. Have fun. Is your toothbrush too small?
How'd you know?
Lucky guess.
Try a new adaptive toothbrush. Awesome, thanks.
Shaking cold, these hands are meant to hold.
Think you'll be when all you gotta keep is strong. Move along like I know you do. And even when your hope is gone, move along just to make it through. When your life ends.
it strong. Move along like I know you do. And even when your hope is gone, move along just to make it through. When all you gotta keep is strong, move along like I know you do. And even when your hope is gone, move along just to make it through.
To destroy the earth, they'll have to deal with you first.